here again.
I think the guys are looking great. I'm really excited on how they came back off ice training and, you know, how they're doing and during the open ice sessions, and couldn't be happier in how we're looking. Certainly we're, you know, 1 weekend of practice. So there's a lot of things that we have to fix and get back to playing the way we're going to have to play game time, but I think we're on course. Yeah, so for us, our model right now is just looking at what's next. I mean, we're not going to look over our shoulder, there's no excuses. It's a model that sits on our door going on the ice. There's no excuses. There's no individuals. And, you know, I've been in this long enough. I've had guys come back from injuries and deal with adversity take off with some of their best hockey. I have first-year guys that, you know, work themselves into a lineup, get in, play awesome, and everything takes off from there. So I don't care if we played 33 games or 30 games. My players, have played a ton of hockey before getting here. And the expectations is we're looking forward, we're looking at the next game, and that's our focus. And I can't be say enough to seniors that graduated, and especially the four captains, Mike Faulkner, Alec Robitaille, TJ Schultz, and Travis Snyder. They kept the program moving forward, positive. We had a huge freshman class last year that had loved their experience here, both academically, hockey, socially, and that's kudos to them in the sense that, you know, it's not a typical freshman year as we all would think it. And I'd also have to give a shout out to the professors. I mean, our guys had a great experience in the classroom, did very well. We got another pre-med major that's just passionate about the program here. I think the professors that do an awesome job here did an awesome job. Again, my guys are in the right place, and where we are today is like where we'd be any other year. We're hungry to get playing hockey games, and we're excited to be putting on the Hobart uniform.